In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Google sign-in through your Lovable app. So this is going to allow users to sign in with Google and get an account on your Lovable app. So this would replace or be in addition to email sign-up with an email and password. Google authentication is really great to allow users to sign in easily to your app. This video is going to assume you have a little bit of familiarity with Lovable. If you're brand new to Lovable, check out some of our other videos in our channel where we cover Lovable from the very beginning. But I'm going to assume you already know how to get started, build a simple app, connect to Supabase so that you can have a database, and you kind of have those basics set up. So once you have those basics set up, what you're going to want to do is go to the chat, ask to set up Google authentication, as simple as that. Say, hey, I want users to be able to sign up with Google in my app. Once you do that, it's going to set up all the initial steps, and it's going to ask you for a few key pieces of information. So on the left side, it's going to say, basically, you can see what I asked is, I'd like to add user authentication. I want to add ability to log in with Google only. Don't worry about privacy for generated apps. Don't worry about that. This is basically like a web, I'm building an AI prototyping app. So you can prototype simple designs. If we go down, what it said is it's going to kind of go through that process. It created the dedicated authentication page for Google sign-in, user authentication state management with context, UI components for login, logout, fixed. There was a terminal component that was missing. So basically, then it's going to tell you what to do. You need to configure Google OAuth in your Supabase project. Go to authentication providers, Google, and add your Google OAuth credentials. So to do that, it's going to give you a link. So I can go ahead and just click that. And then here we are in the authentication for Supabase. We're going to scroll down and you're going to find Google. And you want to click on that. So once you click Google, you're going to check this on for enable sign-in with Google. And then there's going to be two pieces of information here that you're going to need to add. And we get these from Google itself. So let me show you how to do that. You need to go to Google Cloud, create an account on Google Cloud. You can sign in with your Gmail account. Then it's as simple as going to the top and searching for Google OAuth platform. So go ahead and click on that. And then once you're in the Google OAuth platform, we're going to go to clients on the left side. And then what you do is you would go ahead and you create a client. So click create client. You select web application. You can name it. And then what you want to do is this information, you can fill in partially from the information Supabase gave. So this callback URL here that Supabase has for OAuth, you want to copy that. We're going to go back to the Google setup. We're going to add that here. And we don't have to worry about right now authorized JavaScript origins, I don't believe. And then we can go ahead and click create. So once you create that, you can see we have a client ID. So you just go ahead, you copy that client ID, you paste it in here. And then if we click edit OAuth, and then you open the screen a little bit, make sure you have a wide enough screen. Here, you can see a client secret. So you copy that, and then you paste in that client secret right there. And then the one other thing, I'm not 100% sure if it's necessary, but I did it and it ended up working for me. So under authorized JavaScript origins, go ahead and click this and paste in the URL when you preview your Lovable project. Basically you go to Lovable, preview it, and then enter in the URL there. So it can be a subdomain of Lovable unless you've published your app to an actual domain, and then you can put that actual domain where it started with. Once you have all of that set up, then we go back to Supabase, we go ahead and click save. Now we would have Google authentication set up. I'm going to go back and basically it went and built it. And at this point, it should work. I did have an error when I tested it with that redirect URI mismatch. And that's where I was saying you want to get that from Supabase and then paste that in the way that I showed you for the URL. Oh, there's one more thing you need to do because I got another error here. So you want to go back to before we finish, this is the last thing, and then it worked perfectly for me. Go back to authentication providers. We need to go to URL configuration. And what we need to do is paste in your Lovable site URL here. And then we go ahead and click save. This is the URL that Google is going to redirect back to once it's signed the user in. So it's as simple as that. Just go ahead, make those changes, and you should be able to set up Google authentication in your app, and it'll all work perfectly. So if you have any questions, let me know. Leave a comment below. Be sure to check out the link in the description. Go to No-Code MBA if you want to learn more about building with AI and no-code tools from experts in the industry with in-depth tutorials that help you build from start to finish. And subscribe to our channel to get more free videos like this right here. Thanks again for watching. In a future video, I'm going to show you more about what I have built here in Lovable, because I think it is pretty cool and one of the more complex apps that I've seen someone build in Lovable. So I'll definitely share it with you soon. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you in the next video.